Because you are the children of germs. We are all children of germs. For every, in every genome, for 23,000 human genes, you've got 2.5 trillion germ genes. Which means, you imagine the contribution of parents, 23,000 divided by 2.5 trillion. My mathematics is not good. It will not be 1 in a million. You may have some features of your father or mother or something like that. But what is evolution is environment. If you live like your father, you follow what your father did, you smoke like your father, you eat like a pig like your father, and drink like a fish, not what the fish drinks, you will certainly get what the father had. In short, evolution is environmental and not genetic. Let's forget the genes for a minute. Today we know with your mind you can change your genes also. You just do real meditation, you can even increase the size of the telomere at the end of the chromosome, which is a sign of your aging. When you age, the telomere becomes smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. With meditation, it becomes bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And you can change. Bhushan was talking about lifestyle diseases. Lifestyle diseases are lifestyle diseases. I'll tell you what happens. We were hunter-gatherers in the forest some 10,000 years ago before we came to Pune. And what were we doing there? We had to protect ourselves from tigers and lions, snakes, all kinds of things. Nature said, let people survive there also. So nature gave us an autonomic nervous system. If I said God, all of you will be angry because you don't believe in God now. And once you go to BSc level, you forget God. But do you know what Max Planck, the greatest physicist, said about God? God said, science ends in God, religion starts with God. That's all the difference. For religion, you must start with God, otherwise people don't follow you. For science, you go on science, 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 you come to quantum physics, then you say, without God, nothing happens here. It doesn't run like a clock, what Newton and Einstein said. There's a different world altogether. Newton's world and Einstein's world is different from the real, what is called the quantum worldview. I'll come to that later. Now anyway, so what did nature do? Gave you an autonomic nervous system to protect you. So the sympathetic system and the parasympathetic system. Now when you saw a tiger and you want to run away from the tiger to survive, so to run you require glucose, to run you require your blood pressure to go up, to run you require your heart rate to go up, to run you require energy. All this comes from the stimulation of the sympathetic system. You get adrenaline coming. When the adrenaline comes to the liver, nature has kept gunny bags of sugar in the liver called glycogen. So it stimulates the liver and neoglucogenesis, new sugar comes out. So you see the tiger there, your sugar goes up. Then you see the tiger you want to run, your blood pressure goes up because the adrenaline. Your heart rate goes up, chronotropicity, everything goes up. And then you run for your life. And if you survive, all these things have come down. Now we have transplanted ourselves into society in the last 10,000 years, but our physiology is the same. We have same tigers now in the form of human beings. It may be your boss who is a tiger, it may be your wife who is a tiger, it may be your husband who is a tiger, it may be your junior colleague who is a tiger, it may be the peon in the principal's office who is a tiger. Now when you see that tiger, the same reaction occurs inside, but you can't run away from the tiger. Supposing your wife is a tiger, how can you run away from the wife? So your blood pressure goes up and you stand there and watch there and your blood pressure goes up and up and up. After some time it is up. That is what is called high blood pressure. Your sugar is up, that's called diabetes. Your cholesterol is up because cholesterol is not a disease, but cholesterol has to go up because cholesterol is the base of all other steroids that are needed for your stress. So all these are diseases. Now what do we do in reductionist science? I give you a pill, a chemical poison. I tell you what these are. And then what happens? You are happy. I have taken the pill. I have taken it from Dr. Bhushan, who is a very good doctor. Your blood pressure comes down. Why does the blood pressure come down? One scientist tried to find out. What did he do? He had a chip made. It's called the MIT chip. Mitochondrial chip. And this chip can track the drug. If you tag it on, wherever the drug goes, it tags it. So he gives the drug, tags it onto the chip, and then follows it. And he found that every reductionist chemical drug that he used was accepted first, goes into the stomach. The body's wisdom says, oh, this I have not seen it. My forefathers have not seen it. My generation has not seen it. It must be a poison. So it must be eliminated, goes to the river. So every drug that you take from A to Z first goes to the liver and the liver tries to destroy it. That is why after every drug, 24 hours to 48 hours later, you see your liver function test, it's altered. Then, sometimes the liver cannot destroy the whole thing. Some of it comes out, which is called first pass effect. This first pass effect was known to us even when I was a pharmacology student. But our professors didn't know what is first pass effect. Now we know what it is. Now then what we do, that is not enough. So we now know pharmacokinetics, pharmacodynamics. So we give more dose, more drug. And all these do what is called adverse drug reactions, ADR. So mind you, every drug has an adverse drug reaction. Every drug may not be useful to you, but every drug has an adverse drug reaction. That's why I coined this phrase, while there is no pill for every ill, there is an ill following every pill. It's absolutely true. It's out of experience, long experience I have said, for every pill, there is an ill. So I tell doctors, tell the patient before you give a tablet, two things, A, NNT, B, ADR. NNT is number needed to treat, because all our drugs are statistically significant. Not useful for everybody that you give. Supposing I give you a drug like statin, let us say. The NNT is 300, which means 1 in 300 people whom I prescribe statin will get benefit. So some of us, you know, are fanatics, they say, okay, 1 in 300 chance I'll get benefit out of statin, I'll take it. Then tell him what is the ADR risk, 5%. That means 299 people who take the drug unnecessarily have 5% risk of almost dying. So now look at the whole balance. One patient gets benefit, 299 don't get benefit. 6 into 299 is about 18, 17 people. 17 people die. So in the balance, I have given statin to 300 Poonites and I can be very certain of benefit for one person. And I'm absolutely certain of harm to 17 people. Nice, isn't it? Now the largest study of antihypertensive drugs in the what is called the MRC, mild to moderate hypertension study, which is published in 1985, showed NNT for antihypertensive drugs is 850 to benefit one patient with the fond hope of stroke or heart attack avoidance in the next 5 years. I am harming 850 people unnecessarily. And there, of course, the ADR risk is 2%, which means 8.5 into 2 is 16 people. 16 people will die in the next 5 years. One man might be saved, might be saved. What is the balance? If you know all this, will you take these drugs? Now you can study this study, MIT study, mitochondrial study, write down. Mitochondria as chi, chi means energy. Mitochondria as chi, C-H-I. In Chinese language is energy. And the man's name is Wallace, W-A-L-L-A-C-E, D-C Wallace, Douglas C. Wallace. He's a professor of genetics in Washington University. And the article is in a journal called Genetics. 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 Okay? Year is 2004. I'm sorry, 2008. Volume is 179. And page is 727. Please read this. All these articles are free, in the internet. Read that. And go and read it. It's a 10-page article. It will take at least 2 days to understand it, because it's very complicated genetics in it. And very interesting message is, the Ayurvedic drugs which he tried, not from India, the Tibetan drugs, herbal drugs he tried, they were not having any one of these reactions. It goes inside and attacks and gets digested, goes into the system, does good or doesn't do good, but doesn't harm. And doesn't go to the liver. So the liver is... Today we have an epidemic of what's called non-alcoholic cirrhosis, which I have never heard when I was a student in the 50s. Only alcoholics used to get cirrhosis. Now ordinary people, anybody goes to the doctor and says, slight touch of fatty liver. My God, I get about 100, 150 consultations, free consultations, the email every day. Half of it is fatty liver. I went for a checkup. I have a fatty liver. And for a change today, I had a Delhi University professor, senior professor, who wrote to me, Professor Hegde, I'm coming to 65. I have not seen a doctor so far. My wife pesters me every day, must have a checkup. Do you think I must have a checkup? I was so happy. I said, don't have a checkup. You are 65 because you didn't see a doctor. And you'll be 100 if you're destined to be 100. If you go to a doctor, there's a good possibility that you'll not see the 67th birthday. Delhi University professor. He said, I have kept my records roughly from the age 5, I remember. till today, I might have spent about 100 rupees with the doctor. Can you believe that? Delhi University professor, senior professor. I was so happy for a change. After a number of years, I am getting this. Because everybody says, I have not had a checkup. Somebody asked, did you have a checkup? I said, I have not had a checkup. But I don't tell them that. You know, because I always believe in Ayurveda. The Ayurveda has a beautiful definition of health. What is the definition of health in the Western medicine? 1947 Alma Ata definition. Absence of physical, mental, spiritual, emotional, environmental, this, that, disease. Which means it's a business definition, which was done with the business purpose. If you want to know you're healthy or not, you must go to the doctor. Which means you must go for a checkup. It's a good business, isn't it? See, checkup is the biggest business.